So this way we can make sure the game will run on pretty good machine. So, okay, now for the interesting part, the guys want to talk about the assets pipeline, naming, design flow, and some of the big challenges in the network solution. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Rafael, lead programmer at Acuris Game Studio. And I was one of the main developers of the game you were seeing. As I don't have much time, I won't go deeply into any topic, and I will focus on the main challenges you will face during the development of huge projects like this. First, I'll talk on how we've solved the asset pipeline issue from a tech point of view. As we have large amount of weapons, items, maps, we need a way to automate import and build process. We also need ways to decrease memory's footprint. We started the development of this title using lots of manually setup for items, weapons, and stuff like that, and it was kind of buggy. We then started thinking about how could we solve this issue. Then we developed a directory setup that we are using to control our project. And with this directory setup in mind, we were able to create tools for automating import pipeline. We are not using a fully automated pipeline, import pipeline, because it is very buggy too. But we are using a merge of the human intelligence portions of the project, reducing the build time a lot. And here you can see the screen where we can select what will get built when you need to build something. We made it simple so anyone on the team is able to use it. One of the biggest issues we experienced during the development of our FPS game is related to memory control and optimization. By using asset bundles, we have a more accurate way of knowing what is loaded, what is not loaded, and we have some methods to load and unload assets during runtime. We've built some controllers from where any code in the game can ask for assets to be loaded and unloaded, centralizing all the operations so it's easier for deploy. For maps, we have a custom loader that will also unload the map and all related stuff when the player goes back to title menu. Make it easier to understand, I've compiled an overview of the system. Item controller also has an internal cache system.